Greetings. Title caught your eye, did it? Texas, you're setting dates. Please watch the video. I'll keep this one short. For 2,000 years, part of the Pesach Seder, the Passover feast, was for the Jewish people to declare next year in Jerusalem. It was a declaration. It was a hope. It was a longing. It was a statement of faith, belief, and trust in the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. It was a resolve. It was a commitment. It was a reminder. It was a lifeline. It was an anchor. It was a longing. It was a hope. It was an encouragement. For 2,000 years, every year, they would say, next year in Jerusalem. Well, ponder the following for a moment. Philippians 3:20. But our citizenship is in heaven, and we eagerly await a Savior from there, the Lord Jesus Christ. How are we demonstrating to God? We eagerly await. You are free to wonder and challenge whether we need to demonstrate it. 2 Timothy 4:8. In the future there is laid up for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all who have loved, crave, eagerly look forward to his appearing. Luke 12:37-38. It will be good for those servants whose master finds them watching when he comes. I tell you the truth, he will dress himself to serve, will have them recline at the table, and will come and wait on them. It will be good for those servants whose master finds them ready, even if he comes in the second or third watch of the night. Be watching. Be ready. Remind yourself to be alert. Matthew 24:42. Therefore keep watch, because you do not know the day on which your Lord will come. Ha! See, Texas, you don't know which day. You got me. Be ready every day. Do not think, Jesus comes in 9 months. I can be drunk for 8, then clean up my act. And my video just got derailed. Jump segue. So, I'm in the middle of preparing this material, cogitating on the doctrine of imminence, searching for a verse I recall sheds light on this discussion, and I see that Pastor J.D. Farag has his prophecy Q&A up. I respect Pastor Farag, and even floated the idea past my wife to visit Hawaii this Christmas, so we could visit his church. Alas, details did not work out. But I find he's basically covering the same material. Please give his video a view, because it is an independent treatment of basically this same material. His approach is balanced and genuine, and I respect it. Also, watch his video because he mentions something significant. It's about the new UN resolution, 2234. President of Israel, Bibi Netanyahu, has evidence Obama pushed this. Riddle me this. Many videos proclaim Trump's win was tantamount to a delay, a stay of execution. What if it is really the trigger, the forcing function? If Hillary had won, there would be time. Time for Obama to coordinate with Hillary on their schemes and deceptions. They could have waited patiently and worked slowly undercover, as they did with the Iran nuclear deal. With Donald Trump winning, Obama only has 3 more weeks to wield his power. With Trump coming to power, Obama and the globalists will lose control. Perhaps for decades, a generation. The EU is collapsing with Brexit and Italy leaving. Their utopian fantasy of a one-world government is slipping away. What if Trump, being elected, forces them to now act immediately. First, UN resolution for declaring Israeli occupation, blech, I hate that word, of Israel illegal. And perhaps next, quickly, a UN resolution to declare a Palestinian state carved from Israel. They must include Jerusalem, in part or in whole, be given to the Palestinians, because President Trump has said he will move the U.S. Embassy to Jerusalem. Whatever happens, do not think it surprises God. It does not catch him unawares. Watch and pray. Be ready for the return of the Lord. And expect, be ready for, the rapture this year. Even if we need to say that for another 2,000 years. Seriously, while we think these are the last days, so did the believers 2,000 years ago. 1 John 2:18, children, it is the last hour. And just as you heard that Antichrist is coming, even now many Antichrists have appeared. From this, we know it is the last hour. Whether it is or not, live your life like it is. May the Lord find you doing what you were called to do when He returns. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.